Hi, my name is Ruby, and this is my story. So, I was raised in a Christian home, and I go to a Christian school, which is Ankeny Christian Academy, and I've been attending Saylorville for almost all my life. So in first grade, I was sitting in chapel, and the teacher was talking about like how to get saved and what that means. And I asked myself, like, how do I get saved? So I went up to my teacher, which was Miss Klein, and I asked her, how do I get saved? And so we both walked out of the chapel room, and she went to get my mom, who worked at the office at the time, and all three of us went into Miss Klein's room, and they both prayed for me to get saved. So I got saved, but there was no change or difference. I was still like living the same way as I was before. Fast forward a couple years into like sixth grade, I was not living my life for Christ, and I was like bitter towards Christianity, and like every time people like preached about the Bible or anything, I just got so angry for some reason. And yeah, I just wasn't in a good place. And so like my parents figured this out and stuff, and so they like sat me down and talked about Jesus' death and resurrection, but I still didn't care. And my dad asked me this question, like, if you and your friends were driving together and suddenly this car comes out of nowhere and hits you, where would you go after you die? And I remember like kind of questioning that and thinking about it, but I still brushed it off. I didn't care. About a day after that, my sister-in-law, Arlene, and my brother, Cole, and my sister, Maya, and I, we all went to Arlene's niece's birthday party, and we were driving, and we were near the stop sign, so I was kind of falling asleep. And then we hear this thud, and we all kind of jerk forward, and it turns out that this giant van had hit us and hit the back of our car. So, and then we figured out that the van had hit directly on my side, and then my dad's question like came back to me, like, where would you go after you die? And I knew I'd go to hell, so that like the Holy Spirit tugged on my heart. The next day I asked my parents and I said, I want to be saved. And so they sat me down and walked me through Romans and other verses. And so they explained to me that no one's perfect and that we all deserve the punishment of death. And Romans 3:23 says that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. But then they explained to me that God loves us and that he sent his only son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sins. And then he defeated death. And then 3 days later, he rose from the dead and so that we could have eternal life with him. And Ephesians 2:4-5 says, but God being rich in mercy because of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in our trespasses, made us live together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. And when they explained that to me, I understood that we are dead in our sins and we are in need of saving. And we can't save ourselves, but Christ offers up that free gift of salvation. And I finally accepted that gift. And ever since then, I've been reading my Bible, and I'm no longer like angry when people preach about the Bible. Like, I want to hear about that stuff, and I've just been desiring to know more about Christ. I want to be baptized because it's Jesus' command, and I want to follow that command and take that next step. So.